Peace be with you. Welcome to Sunday Mass with Children. We are so glad that you can join us on this adventure to learn more about our faith.
Thank you for sharing your amazing artwork with us week after week on Little Faith Steps. The entries from our local and international friends are colourful and encouraging. We are always inspired by sharing that beautiful artwork. Keep them coming.
Hi kids, welcome to episode 2 of Power Up with the Holy Spirit. Last week, we learned about who the Holy Spirit is and why we need Him. Today, we are going to learn more about how the Holy Spirit helps and guides us to be a better Christian. Let us begin with a prayer and a song to Jesus.
Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us the Holy Spirit. Open our minds, our ears, and our hearts, so that we can learn more about Him today. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Let's sing this song to remind ourselves to always love the Lord with all our hearts, with all our souls, with all our minds, and with all our strength.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. Serve the Lord with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, and with all my strength. I will serve the Lord with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, and with all my strength. With all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength. I will serve the Lord.
Hi children, come join us. When we sing, I will love you, you echo the words and actions, I will love you. When we sing, I will serve you, you echo, I will serve you. Are you ready? Let's do this together.
I will serve you.
Children, do you remember what we talked about last week? About turning on that Holy Spirit switch and powering up with the Holy Spirit? You were probably thinking, Uncle Mark, how to turn on? I have no switch. Is it my nose? Or is it my ears? No, it's not. You know, there is a very simple way I do it. And I can turn it on whenever I'm feeling scared, when I'm in trouble, or just before I start the day. Do you want to know how I turn on that switch? Just as how we speak to Jesus, we can also speak to the Holy Spirit in prayer. We can just say, Come, Holy Spirit, come. Now, children, come join me to say it together. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Now, let's do it together. One, two, three. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come into my heart.
Children, do you know that just as how we greet our parents every morning, you can also greet the person of the Holy Spirit and ask Him to help you throughout the day? You can say, Come, Holy Spirit, into my heart and guide me to be a good and loving child. Give it a try this week.
We also learned last week about who the Holy Spirit is and why we need the Holy Spirit. He is our helper. The apostles were filled with the Holy Spirit on Pentecost, and they went out to share the good news of Jesus with everyone. That day was the beginning of church. That's why Pentecost is the birthday of our church. About 3,000 people joined the apostles that day.
But how can the Holy Spirit help us?
The Holy Spirit helps us by giving us gifts to guide us to be faithful and truthful Christians.
Gifts? More gifts? I love gifts. Do I have these gifts?
Yes, John, the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And yes, you already have these gifts in you. You were given them at baptism. And yes, these special gifts power us up to bring the love of God to others. Do you know what these gifts are?
Oh yes, Mom, I remember the song you taught me to help me remember these gifts. Wisdom, understanding, right judgment, and fortitude. Knowledge and reverence, wonder and awe.
Actually, John, I have all the gifts of the Holy Spirit in this bag. Shall we dig into this bag and see what each gift means?
Yes, yes, may I?
Sure.
What are these glasses for? Oh, I think they can help me to see clearer after so many hours of screen time. Wow, now I have perfect vision.
Awesome.
That's right, John. Just as the glasses help you to see clearly, the gift of wisdom allows us to see the things around us clearly. The gift of wisdom is seeing with God's eyes, listening with God's ears, feeling with God's heart, and speaking with God's love. Whenever you find it hard to love your brother or sister who has annoyed you, ask the Holy Spirit for the gift of wisdom to help you to love them even though it seems so hard for you to do.
Oh, so if I put on God's custom-made glasses, then I'll be able to see how I can love the people around me just as God does.
You've got it. Now take another gift from this bag.
Ooh, a light bulb? What does this symbolize?
Just as the light bulb shines its light to light up the whole room so that we can see in the dark, the gift of understanding sheds light upon us so that we can understand more about God. For example, when your mommy or daddy ask you to clean your room and put away the toys, but you don't want to and complain about why you have to do it, ask the Holy Spirit for the gift of understanding to light up your mind. You may then understand that if you don't clean up, then someone may trip over the mess or the toys and then get injured. See how the Holy Spirit enlightens our minds?
Here, John, pick another one.
Ooh, Ah, it's a Bible. Wow, that's a lot of pages to read, Mom. Mm-hmm.
It sure is. But just as the Bible tells us what is right and wrong of us to do, the gift of right judgment empowers us to know what to do and how to do it. This gift helps us to know right from wrong so that we can avoid sin and live as God wants us to live. It's like playing a game of tic-tac-toe. Just as you need to decide on the right place to put your crosses or circles in a game of tic-tac-toe, you can ask the Holy Spirit for the gift of right judgment to guide you on where to put your feet next to make the right decision so that you can do everything that is good and pleasing to God. Another gift.
Tortoise?
John, do you know the story of the tortoise and the hare? Just as the tortoise is steadfast and faithful in its task, the gift of fortitude helps us to persevere in times of difficulty. Like when someone in school bullies us by calling us names, we get hurt and angry. Why does God allow this to happen? This is when we can ask the Holy Spirit for the gift of fortitude that will help us to continue to love God and to get through these painful situations.
Let us now listen to a story of a saint who was laughed at and called the dumb ox by his classmates.
Mm-hmm.
St. Thomas Aquinas' classmates used to laugh at him for being large, slow, and quiet in class. They called him the dumb ox. However, all his teachers were impressed with how much he knew. When he was 20 years old, Thomas joined the Dominican friars to teach people about Jesus. The friars were poor. His family was not happy because they wanted Thomas to bring money home. His brothers kidnapped him from the friars and imprisoned him in a castle. There, his mother, sisters, and brothers tried to change his mind, but Thomas was determined to remain a friar. His mother finally let him go after 1 year. Thomas returned to the friars and went on to write many important works. Knowing that all his wisdom came from God, he remained humble and prayed every time before he worked. In fact, he learned more from Jesus on the crucifixion than from his books. Thomas also loved the Blessed Sacrament so much that he composed hymns and prayers to honor Jesus in the Eucharist. After Jesus appeared to him in a vision, he said, "I can write no more. I have seen things that make my writings like straw." Yet, the wisdom of St. Thomas Aquinas is still studied today.
St. Thomas Aquinas was humble and never forgot to pray before he worked. He is a model for us to follow. Let us sing this song to the Holy Spirit, who is so present in our lives.
Spirit of the living God, Spirit of the living God, we only want to hear your voice. We're hanging on every word. Spirit of the living God, Spirit of the living God, we want to know you more and more. We're hanging on every word. 'Cause when you speak, when you move, when you do what only you can do, it changes us, it changes what we see. And what do we see when you come in the room? When you do what only you can do, it changes us, it changes what we see. And what we see, it's changing changes what we see. And what we see when you come in the room, when you do what only you can do, it changes us, it changes what we see. And what we see is when you speak, when you move, when you do what only you can do, it changes us, it changes what we see.
For this week's activities, go to our Facebook page, Little Faith Steps. Like our page and share your works in the comments section with us. We can't wait to see them.
Oh, and mummies and daddies, don't forget to access Little Faith Steps' Facebook page during the week. We'll be posting the worship songs there. Look out for them.
It is now time to set up your altar table and prepare for Holy Mass. Take a moment now to get these items and see you in a while.
Oh, don't forget to take a photo and post it on Facebook or Instagram with the hashtag CatholicMarsAtHome.
Let us now listen to what Auntie Estella has to share with us in one Mass minute.
Now that you've found out more about the Holy Spirit, let's look at how He comes to be with us at Mass. We know that during Mass, Father puts a wafer of bread onto the paten. He pours wine and water into the chalice. But that's all they are, bread, water and wine. How do they turn into the body and blood of Jesus? Something's got to happen, something beyond any human power. Right after the Holy Holy, once all of us are kneeling, the priest asks God the Father to send down the Holy Spirit to make these gifts holy and turn them into Jesus' body and blood. This is the epiclesis, a Greek word which means calling down on. With these words, Father makes a sign over the bread and wine. Doesn't it look like something is falling from his hands down onto the bread and wine? You might also think that Father's hands look like the wings of a bird. When Jesus was baptized, the Holy Spirit came down from heaven in the form of a dove and rested on him. When you see the epiclesis, think of that dove. The Holy Spirit has come to be with us.
Thank you, Auntie Estella. Let us now settle down, sit in front of your altar table, take a moment to be silent and prepare for Holy Mass.
Welcome, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to the Holy Mass with children. Thank you for joining us to sing songs of praise and learning more about the gifts of the Holy Spirit. There's nothing like giving God our hands and our voices to worship Him as our loving Father. Let us now worship the Lord together on the seventh Sunday of Easter, 16th May 2021. We offer up this Mass for peace in the world that we may love God as God loved us. Join us in singing the processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to this celebration of the seventh Sunday of Easter. This is the last Sunday of Easter, the last week before we celebrate Pentecost and end the season of Easter. This Sunday, we also celebrate World Communication Sunday. And I will talk more about what World Communication Sunday is about in the homily later. We pray for the world, especially in terms of the current pandemic that's going on, also in Singapore, and that's why we are experiencing more restrictions. We hope that those who are afflicted will recover. We pray that the situation here can improve. And we thank God for the technology that allows us to still worship Him. And we pray especially for this media of communications where we can spread the Word of God, we can spread the good news all over the world. And so as we come to celebrate this Eucharist, let us call to mind the times that we may have failed to communicate God's love, the times that we have failed to share the good news with others because of our own selfishness, because of our own weaknesses. Let us pray for God's love and mercy.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and in what I failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy.
Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Saviour of the human race is with you in your glory, may experience as he promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us. He who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. One day, Peter stood up to speak to the brothers. There were about 120 persons in the congregation. Brothers, the passage of Scripture had to be fulfilled in which the Holy Spirit, speaking through David, foretells the fate of Judas, who offered himself as the guide to the men who arrested Jesus. After having been one of our number and actually sharing this ministry of ours. Now in the book of Psalms it says, "Let someone else take his office." We must therefore choose someone who has been with us the whole time that the Lord Jesus was traveling round with us. Someone who was with us right from the time when John was baptizing until the day when he was taken up from us. And he can act with us as a witness to his resurrection. Having nominated two candidates, Joseph known as Barsabbas, whose surname was Justus, and Matthias, they prayed, "Lord, you can read everyone's heart. Show us therefore which of these two you have chosen to take over this ministry and apostolate, which Judas abandoned to go to his proper place." They then drew lots for them, and as the lot fell to Matthias, he was listed as one of the 12 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John. My dear people, since God has loved us so much, we too should love one another. No one has ever seen God. But as long as we love one another, God will live in us. And His love will be complete in us. We can know that we are living in Him and He is living in us because He let us share His Spirit. We ourselves saw and we testify that the Father sent His Son as Savior of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in Him and He in God. We ourselves have known and put our faith in God's love towards ourselves. God is love, and anyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Holy Father, keep those you have given me true to your name, so that they may be one like us. While I was with them, I kept those you had given me true to your name. I have watched over them, and not one is lost, except the one who chose to be lost. And this was to fulfill the scriptures. But now I am coming to you, and while still in the world, I say these things, to share my joy with them to the full. I pass your word on to them, and the world hated them, because they belong to the world, no more than I belong to the world. I am not asking you to remove them from the world, but to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world. And for their sake, I consecrate myself, so that they too may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And so, my dear brothers and sisters, as I mentioned, it's the seventh Sunday of Easter, and it's also the time when the Church celebrates World Communication Sunday, a Sunday which not many people really know about. Maybe for me, because I've always been interested in IT, in media, and how we are called to use media in the church. And so this World Communication Sunday is something which I take notice of. It had begun in 1967 by Pope Paul VI. And he wanted to use this Sunday, one Sunday a year, to emphasize the importance of the opportunities and challenges of how we use the various means of media, whether it be newspapers, radio, television, and of course nowadays, at that time they didn't have the internet, how we use all these different tools for the church to communicate the gospel message. And as I was reflecting, why did they choose the seventh Sunday of Easter? Right, there's so many other Sundays. But I realize It has its significance, whether they intended it or not, because this is the last Sunday before Pentecost, right? Do you know what happened at Pentecost? Pentecost was when the Holy Spirit came down on the apostles and they were sent out. They went to go and share the good news. In a way, World Communication Sunday celebrates this fact, right? What the whole season of Easter is about. The beginning of Easter, we talked about the Alleluia, Jesus Christ is risen. The good news that our Lord and Savior has risen, has defeated sin, defeated death, has given us new life. Of course, as you go through Easter, you realize at the beginning, the disciples themselves didn't really understand what the resurrection was. But as Jesus revealed himself to them, right, the various stories that we heard, the road to Emmaus, Jesus coming to Peter when they went fishing, all these times, Jesus was helping them to understand this message of the resurrection, the message of the good news, which culminates at Pentecost when they went out to share this good news. And so for us, today's readings remind us of this mission. The first reading that we hear, right? Matthias was chosen. For what? Because Judas had betrayed Jesus. He was out of the 12, and so now they only had 11 people. And they say, we need to choose one to replace Judas, and they chose Matthias. Was it because they just liked the number 12? No, it was because they wanted somebody not just to make up the numbers, but to go and share the good news. Or as what was said, we need to have someone who actually experienced the resurrection so that he can be a witness. We see the same thing in the second reading. It says, we saw and testify. And so the disciples who experienced the resurrection were called to go and share the good news. And finally, we see in the gospel, Jesus' prayer for his disciples. He said, I've chosen them, I've called them, I've commissioned them to go into the world to share the good news, to share the truth that Jesus had revealed to them. And this is what we celebrate in World Communication Sunday. What is the message first, and then the how? Many people think that World Communication Sunday is about the internet, it's about the television. All these are just means. Communication does not just involve the how we communicate, but the what do we communicate. What are we communicating with each other? We can use the internet to spread truth or to spread lies, right? I'm sure you heard of the phrase fake news. How do we know whether something is real or is it fake news? Our communication can convey love or anger or hatred. And so what is the content of our communication? What is the content of the things that we want to share with others is most important. Then the second one is, how can we share that? And so when we celebrate World Communication Sunday, we're invited to ask ourselves both the what and the how. I give you an example. Let's say if I want to convey love to somebody, how would I do that? Right? If it's between a husband and wife, you know, maybe on the birthday or anniversary, you might buy some chocolates, buy a rose. That rose communicates love. It could be by writing a letter, or maybe making a phone call. Or love can also be shown by acts of service. Right, in this time when our movement is again restricted, Are we able to look also and see who are our neighbors that might need some help to buy groceries, to buy food? Could we show love and communicate love by little acts of service? And so for us, what are we communicating and how do we communicate? It's an invitation for us to reflect on. But this year, Pope Francis, in his letter for World Communication Sunday, has asked us to reflect on a phrase in the Bible, which is, come and see. I was thinking, how does this come and see reflect communication? And Pope Francis tells us about this invitation. The come and see was something when the two disciples of John the Baptist, in John's Gospel, right, he said, behold the Lamb of God, and his disciples went to follow after Jesus. Jesus said, what are you looking for? They asked, Master, where do you stay? And Jesus said, come and see. That invitation for them to go and encounter the Lord. But this come and see is not just something that Jesus said. Subsequently, in the chapter, we will see that after Philip had met Jesus, he himself went out and he talked to Nathanael. And he said, we have found the Messiah. Nathanael said, are you sure? And Philip said, come and see. Why do we need to come and see? And this is when we talk about our communication. Are we just communicating Jesus, communicating the good news? Or in our communication, do we also invite? Why do we have to invite? Why do we need to come and see? Can't I just stand far away and see? Well, maybe just to share with you, right, in this year that many of us couldn't go and travel. How many of you, you know, are waiting for this to be over so that you can go and travel? Go, even if it's just to Malaysia, right? Or to go to Disneyland. Or to go somewhere in another country. But don't need to, what? We have the internet, right? You can just go and surf the internet and see pictures of places. We watch TV, we can see cities in the US, in China. We can, with the internet these days, we can see so many things at home. Why do we need to go there? Because seeing something just from a distance is very different, right? As much as, you know, even with Google Earth, we can go to other countries, we can even go down to the street view, but it's very different. Why is it different? I share with you when I was studying in the US and I went to New York. People ask me, how is New York? I say New York is actually quite dirty and quite smelly, right? But one thing which was a unique experience for me in New York was seeing the images, the movies that I watched, or even the TV shows. Right, the places where they film, and me being there was an experience of, oh, this is what it is. Watching on TV, you can't smell the smell of New York. New York has a very distinct smell. You can't experience the cold of New York winter, even though if you're watching, you know, I don't know if your age, you all watch the movie Home Alone, right, and all the snow. To experience it firsthand is so much different. And that is where Pope Francis is inviting us, that our communication needs to be something real. This day, we can communicate with people by hiding behind our devices. But are we really getting in touch with people? Even more so, right, we've been having this online masses for more than a year. And despite when we have resumed masses, There are people who say, I can watch online, it's okay. And so they don't go to church. They have not gone to church for nearly a year. You know, I prepared this homily before the announcement of the more restrictions, right? And as much as these restrictions are affecting us at this moment, but I hope when the restrictions are lifted, when we can go for Mass again, invite you, children, right, drag your parents to church. If they don't want to go to church, you tell them you want to go to church. Why? Because I want to come and see. But despite the restrictions that we are undergoing now for the good of our country, right? We stay at home, we use technology. And that's why we have things like the online Mass. We have these ways that we can continue to keep in touch with others, we can still continue to share the good news. So I'd like to invite you to think, what am I going to do? Now, I don't know if or when schools might, you have to go back to home-based learning, right? Most of those of us working have to work from home. We may have more time. Are we communicating? Are we using whatever means that we have to communicate? And what are we communicating? Some people during last year's circuit breaker, right, because they were stuck with their family, and then for some more conflicts happened. But for some, they started to come together as a family to pray, to play, to laugh, to share. Are we able to do that? To start communicating more. Here in the seminary where I am, you know, last year we had 15 of us, and when we couldn't go out, right? So we spent more time together, and we started to learn more about each other, and I was really appreciative of that. Right? We started to share stories about our life, our God experiences, how our journey has been. You know, not that we don't do it in normal days, but we went further in depth, right? We had to come up with creative ways for us to be with one another. And so I'd like to challenge you today. What are you going to communicate? How are you going to communicate? What is the message? Can you all come together as a family to continue to pray? Not just for yourself, but to pray for others. To come together, to talk more. Don't hide behind your computer, your mobile phone, your tablets. To be able to start communicating, to be able to start sharing. And maybe to use the technology to communicate with people outside, right? Your other family members, your friends. And more importantly, can you share the good news? Last year, for those of you who were watching the All Saints Day, the Mass, when we talked about the All Saints app, not the All Saints app, All Saints Instagram filter. I'm not sure how many of you did try it. That was one of the ways that we could use technology to share about our faith. So maybe this time, think how you can share your own story, your own encounter of Jesus, the resurrected Lord, how He has given you life, how He has given you blessings, how you can share that with others, whether using old technology like pen and paper or the new technologies like social media, like emails. Let us pray as we celebrate World Communication Sunday that the Word of God, the truth of God, may continue to be spread so that more and more people can come to know Him. Amen. And so, having heard the word of God, let us respond by professing our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We are called to be witnesses of the truth of Jesus' resurrection. Let us pray for the needs of the world to which we proclaim that truth.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop William Goh, all priests and religious, that they may be servants whom the Lord upholds and upon whom he rests his spirit, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For leaders of the world, that the Lord anoints and empowers them to always make the right decisions for the good of all people, even when it is hard, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church throughout the world, that it may be a shining light in the darkest times, bringing help and comfort to all those in need, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. In this month of May, we pray with Pope Francis, seeking the intercession of Mary, our Mother, and asking God, the Father of Mercies, to bring an end to the pandemic and the death and suffering experienced by so many throughout the world. We pray in particular for the people of India and those nations ravaged by the resurgence of COVID-19, that they can get the help they need without delays. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have yet to come to faith, or those who have lost their faith, that they may be consecrated in the truth of God's word, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the intentions we hold silently in our hearts and those who have asked for our prayers, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Holy Father, guard and protect us from the evil one. Consecrate us in your truth to carry your word into the world. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim.
Sanctus,
you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of our holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which shall be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and William our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Just as Jesus taught his disciples, we who have become sons and daughters of the Father, we pray to God our Father in the words our Savior taught us.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold Jesus, who reveals the love and the truth of the Father. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
So for those of you watching at home, invite you to enter into this time of spiritual communion to pray and ask for God's blessings and graces, especially during this period, to pray and ask the Lord to help you to encounter him, help you to want to bear testimony and to share the good news with others.
We invite all those watching to make an act of spiritual communion. With a spirit of gratefulness, thanking God for his infinite love and sacrifice. With humble and contrite hearts, let us express our desire to invite Jesus into our souls. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let's pray. Hear us, O God, our Saviour, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ her head, he who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Music by Jesus.
parents, would you like some faith formation through fun activities for your children this June holiday? Come join the Virtual Bible Arts Camp 2021, a collaboration between Belief Ministry and Office for the New Evangelization. And this year's BAC hopes to help your child face their fears and challenges with Jesus. In this camp, your child will encounter Jesus through scripture and learn how to overcome their challenges with faith, hope and courage through the art forms of dance, music, art and drama. For more information, scan this QR code and visit our website. We have limited spaces, so register now to secure your place.
Oh wait, parents, we even have a special segment just for you and prayer performance that is for everyone on the last day. Find out more on our website, Belief Ministry.
See you there!
Our church has gone through many milestones in her life. And there is much to be thankful for as we look back on the many sacrifices that were made to build the church that we have today. As our church strives to continue to rise above the current, may our hearts burn with love and zeal to grow and enliven the lives of the many people. Let us reignite and shine our faith by supporting our church, as her mission is still very much growing, and now, more than ever, needs your support.
Many of us don't understand why we give. Very often when we give, we think that we are doing God a favor, doing the church a favor, or doing some people a favor. Actually, when you give, you do yourself the greatest favor, more than anything else. God is life-giving. Unless we are life-giving, we cannot share in the life of God. And this is where we are challenged to ask ourselves, how do we use the resources that the Lord has blessed us with? Because at the end of the day, we are accountable to God, to our fellow men, how we use what the Lord has blessed us to. We are called to share and deepen our faith. Do you have faith in God's providence? Do you believe that God will bless you when you bless others? God cannot be outdone in generosity.
Catholic Foundation is here to invite Catholics to be part of this mission of the Church, to be generous to the degree that they're able to, but more importantly, to feel that they are part of the Church, that they have a stake in the mission of the Church, that they want the Church to develop, to grow. Your support is important, and everyone can be responsible, and everyone should be responsible to make sure that the Church fulfills its mission.
God inviting us to be generous is simply inviting us to experience a joy that only He can give us, because He is the one who first shows us what is generosity.